Okay, so I've been, kinda neglecting all you CapCut users, and I'm sorry about that, but it ends today, because cinematic color grading in CapCut, that's what we're gonna do. Look, all these examples took me literally just 5 minutes to do, so this is the easiest and fastest way to color grade in CapCut, while still having full control over the result. And, equally important, I did all of this in the free version of CapCut. Let's do it. Okay, so this first step is for any one of you who shoots log. Now, what does that mean, shooting in log? Well, if you use some kind of log profile on your camera and your footage looks like this, flat, no saturation, no contrast. But the advantage of shooting in a log profile is that your camera will capture more information and more dynamic range. If you're using a normal standard profile and your footage looks normal, like this, it has contrast and saturation, well, then you can actually skip this step and just go to the next chapter. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is make our log footage look normal. We need to add contrast and saturation. There are different ways to do that. You could use a LUT that's specifically designed for your camera, or you could do it manually, and that's what we're gonna do here. So first, click on the three lines here. Select Color Oscilloscope and then Show. And these waveforms and the vector scope will make it easier. It will help you to make the right decisions. Then make sure your clip is selected and go to Adjustment and then Curves. First, we're gonna add contrast. And the easiest way is by creating an S-shaped Luma curve. That's the top one, so the white one. Just make some anchor points by clicking on that line and then drag it into an S-shaped curve. And look at the waveform here. So what we want to do is expand that waveform. Pull the shadows down and the highlights up. Expand the midtones without going too far, without clipping or crushing anything. See, this is clipping the highlights. It means that the info at the top there is just gone. So in that case, just bring it back by adjusting the highlights in the curves. And that's the top part of the curve. The bottom part of the curve is the shadows. And the middle part, obviously, is the midtones. It's that easy. Or is it? Because, you see, the thing is, there's not one curve that will work for all your footage. You might have to tweak the curve a little bit in the shadows or the highlights or the midtones, depending on what your image looks like, what you shot. And also, it's not exact science. So, you know, some people like a lot of contrast, some people don't. Maybe you like a bit brighter midtones or darker, maybe you don't. But always start with an S-curve and then go from there. I'm not gonna hold your hand here and tell you where to put everything. I'm just showing you the workflow and then it's up to you. You can only learn all this by doing it a lot. Okay, and then once you're done with the curve, saturation. Easiest thing in the world, go back to basic here and crank up the saturation. That's it. And then finally, all you need to do, depending again on what your image looks like, a little bit of color correction. So adjust the tint or white balance. Is your image too warm or too cold? Adjust the white balance. If it's too green or too magenta for your liking, adjust the tint. That's it. And again, this is not exact science unless you're going for something super specific. You know, if you want perfectly clean whites, well, then you're gonna have to be a bit more specific, yeah. But the important thing here, the thing that I want you to do is just practice, you know, move a slider, move the curve, look at what it does, and then process it here in your brain. And then practice, 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 practice. That's the most important thing. Okay, now before we get to the actual color grading, I want to talk about your music, because chances are that you're not using music from Audio, the sponsor of this video. All the music in my videos is from Audio, but maybe you're using CapCut's library or a random free music website. And let me be clear, there's nothing wrong with that. But I do have two questions for you. First of all, are you happy with the quality of your music? Because Audio not only offers high quality music ranging from cinematic to electronic and rock and soul, but they also offer high quality search features to make it easier for you to find the perfect song. And secondly, are you 100% sure that you won't run into any copyright issues? Also important. If you decide to use Audio, you can use everything for social media and personal work, as well as client work, without worrying about copyright. And you can now get a 1-year subscription for Audio Pro for just $59. That's 70% off. Just use my link and code in the description. Go check them out, Audio. Okay, now back to the color grading. This is by far the easiest part of the tutorial. We're gonna apply a filter. So go to filters here, and if you're using the free version, not all of them will be available, but still more than enough. And then just pick one that you like, drag it on the timeline, and boom. But here's the thing, it doesn't have to be exactly 100% to your liking, because now the actual color grading starts, and we can still adjust anything we did before to make it look exactly like you want it. And I'm gonna show you a few different tools. You don't have to use all of them, but you know, just try them out. And by the way, you also don't have to use a LUT if you don't want to. It's just a little extra. It makes it a little bit easier to get a creative look, but you don't have to. Okay, first back to the basic adjustments. And well, you know, don't underestimate the basic adjustments. We can adjust the white balance and tint again, like I showed you before, in case you don't like the tint or white balance that the filter gives you. But you can also change the contrast here by using the shadows, highlights, and the contrast slider. And the brilliance slider basically raises the midtones to make everything feel a bit brighter. It pops more. But for now, I'm gonna leave everything like it is here. And you can actually do almost everything available in the basic adjustments, also in the curves. But the difference is that these sliders are easier to use than the curves, but you have less control over everything. So, you know, up to you what you prefer, but you can get great results using either of these. And then finally, let's tweak the actual colors of our image. And I'm gonna show you two important tools. First of all, HSL. Here you can pick a color and then change the tint, the saturation, or the lightness of that color. For example, let's say here I want the sky to look a bit more teal, greenish, instead of warm blue, you know, purplish blue. Well, just select blue here and then drag the tint slider towards teal. And see how easy it is? So this is where you can tweak the colors that you didn't like after applying that filter. You can still customize it the way you want. Here's another example. Maybe you want the greens to look a bit more yellow here. Well, just play around with the yellow and green dot here, or make them a bit brighter or darker. Less saturation maybe, or more. It's all possible, just don't overdo it. You know, color grading is the art of making something look naturally unnatural, or unnaturally natural. Yeah, it really is. And then the last tool I want to show you is maybe the most interesting tool, but also the most complicated one, the RGB curves. But you'll see, once you get how it works, once you understand, it's not that complicated. So if you go to the curves, the top one, the Luma curve, that's the one we've used before to adjust the contrast. It affects the whole image, all the colors, all the channels and the tones. So basically contrast and exposure, yeah. But the other curves, RGB, only affect one channel. Red, green, or blue. And so you can adjust colors in shadows, highlights, and midtones. Because remember, the lower part of the curve is the shadows, the middle part is the midtones, and the highest part, the top part, is the highlights. So, for example, maybe you want the shadows to look a bit more cyan, tealish. Well, just go to the red channel and use the bottom of the curve, the shadows. If you pull them down, it will remove red from the shadows and add the opposite color, cyan. But if I do it like this, see, even though I'm mainly moving the bottom half of the curve, the shadows, the rest is also moving, the midtones and the highlights, which means that it's also affecting the midtones and the highlights. So if you don't want that, just create anchor points and you'll have full control over the adjustment. What else can we do? Maybe you want a bit more yellow in the highlights. For example, I'm just making simple examples here. Well, just go to the blue channel and pull the highlight part of the curve down. This will remove blue and add yellow to the highlights. And that's how you use those color curves. Now, even more so than the HSL adjustments, be careful here, don't overdo it. Because the example I showed you, like making the shadows a bit more teal, it's dangerous because there's a thin line between, oh, great look and ugh, horrible. So always be careful here. It's better to underdo it a bit than overdo it. And practice a lot. Practice on sunny footage, cloudy footage, beach, forest, you know, all those things will affect the way your image looks and the way these tools behave. So practice, practice, practice. That's the most important thing you should remember from this video. I show you the tools, I show you how they work, Now it's up to you. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.